After 13 years of operations in Russia, Nissan Motor said recently it would sell its business in Russia to the Central Scientific Research Automobile and Automotive Engines Institute, NAMI, for €1. The assets for sale include Nissan's production and research facilities in St. Petersburg, as well as its sales and marketing center in Moscow. The deal is expected to cost Nissan an unusual loss of about $687 million. Renault owns a 43% stake in Nissan, and the decision by its Japanese partner is expected to reduce Renault's net income by $320 million in the second half of 2022. In fact, as early as May, Renault transferred its 68% stake in Automotive, Russia's largest automaker, to NAMI for a nominal price of 1 ruble. Against this backdrop, however, there is a force that is growing unbelievably. In fact, in recent months, Chinese automakers have begun to aggressively seize the Russian market. In April, the proportion of Chinese cars was only 12.6%, rose to 16.9% in May, and reached 21% in June. So, when other brands have left Russia, why did only Chinese cars choose to stay? Is the huge increase in sales in Russia at this time a good thing for Chinese cars? In other words, is the Russian auto market still worth exploring? Which Chinese car brand does Russia like the most? Hi! Welcome to Auto Age. Before we started today's video, please subscribe to the channel and turn on the notification bell. Okay, let's get started. First of all, it is clear that Russia has a vast territory and sparse population, and its economic development is uneven, resulting in limited domestic purchasing power. Last year, Russia sold 1.67 million vehicles, ranking 8th in the world. By the way, Brazil and South Korea have higher sales than Russia. In addition, there are only a handful of local Russian car brands. Since the second half of 2002, the Russian automobile industry has entered the cold winter. Many large automobile manufacturers have encountered technical problems in the production process, and they had to stop production. Due to historical reasons, Russia's industrial development is mainly focused on heavy industry and military industry. Therefore, auto, as a civilian industry, Russia is very weak in terms of technical strength and the breadth of the industrial chain. After the introduction of foreign auto brands, it has caused a huge impact on local brands. Affected by the Russian-Ukrainian conflict, supply chain problems have become increasingly serious, which is also directly reflected in their car sales. According to data, in July 2022, sales of passenger cars and light commercial vehicles in Russia fell by an astonishing 74.9% year-on-year, a decrease of 94,819 compared with July last year. From January to July this year, Russian car sales were only 368,900, a year-on-year decrease of 69.5%. Since February this year, Volkswagen, Honda, Ford, BMW, Mercedes-Benz, GM, Volvo, Jaguar Land Rover have announced the suspension of car exports and sales to Russia, and many of them have also stopped production in local Russian factories. Unable to retain foreign car companies, and the strength of Russia's own car brands is not strong, leading to the decline of the Russian car market. At this time, there is a voice in Russia: if the Westerners leave the car factories built in Russia, whether the Chinese may be the biggest beneficiaries. After all, under such circumstances, Chinese brands seem to be the only option for Russia. According to the latest data, Chinese brands sold a total of 8,600 new cars in Russia in July this year, and their market share has reached 24%, overtaking the Korean brand for the first time to occupy the second place in the Russian new car sales market. For reference, South Korean brands accounted for 21.2% of sales in July, and the top Russian auto brand accounted for 30.9%. With the withdrawal of Renault, Chinese cars are expected to seize a larger market in Russia in the future. So in May this year, After Renault announced its withdrawal from the Russian car market, Moscow mayor announced that the factory left by Renault would be used to restart the discontinued Soviet-era car brand Moskvich. However, according to the pictures of the Moskvich model released by local media in Russia, it looks like a model of China's JAC Motors. And it is said that Russia is negotiating with JAC Motors to discuss using its design, engineering, and production platform to restart the discontinued Moskvich. Production is expected to start no later than the fourth quarter of 2022, with the production of gasoline-powered vehicles, followed by a shift to electric vehicle manufacturing. In fact, JAC is not the only Chinese car company involved. At present, the Moscow government, KAMAZ Group, and the Russian Ministry of Industry and Trade are negotiating with a number of Chinese auto companies, including JAC, FAW Group, and BYD. However, Russian President Vladimir Putin said that the production of Moskvich will be very difficult, and the whole country is waiting for the results of the work. This actually shows that if Russia wants to develop its own auto industry, it has to rely on China's auto power. In fact, Chinese car companies have already laid out their own industries in the Russian market. As early as June 2019, Great Wall Motors invested $500 million in Tula, Russia, and it took 5 years to build a world-class factory. In addition, Chery is also negotiating with Russian manufacturers to produce cars in Russian factories, and plans to realize localized production in Russia. Looking at the popular models sold in Russia, like many other underdeveloped countries, its low-end models account for a considerable proportion. And Chinese car companies are best at starting from these regions. So, in Russia, what Chinese cars sell best? In fact, most of the sales of Chinese brand cars in Russia in July came from Chery, Geely, Haval, and Exeed. July sales were 2,577, 2,323, 2,155, and 1,012 respectively, of which Chery and Geely ranked in the top five, Haval ranked sixth, and the sales of other brands were less than 200. According to the sales volume announced in July, it means that for every four new cars sold in Russia, one is from a Chinese brand. In addition, Romier, the Russian Social Opinion and Market Research Center, recently released the results of a survey on Chinese auto brands and their satisfaction with their operations in Russia. The five most well-known Chinese auto brands include Chery, 30%, and Lifan, 21%, Geely, 18%, Haval, 10%, and Great Wall, 8%. The results of the study show that 83% of Chinese brand car owners in Russia are relatively or completely satisfied with their cars. Ludmila Fukova, the key account manager of the center, said, "Chinese car brands are gradually gaining a foothold in the Russian market and gradually gaining the trust of buyers." The research results show that among Chinese brand car owners, there is no dissatisfaction with the operation. This suggests that one of the factors for the increased market share of Chinese cars may be the increased customer trust and satisfaction with the cars. Anyway, do you think the huge increase in sales in Russia at this time is a good thing for Chinese cars? In my opinion, due to Russia being sanctioned by European and American countries, some car companies operating in Russia were forced to close their production lines in Russia, which further exacerbated the shortage of cars in the Russian market. As a rigid demand for cars, the growth of Chinese car sales in Russia will continue for a long time. However, the downturn in the Russian auto market will continue for a long time, and there is even a tendency to continue to deteriorate. From this perspective, the penetration of Chinese brands into Russia will not bring real economic benefits, but entering Russia can bring more valuable overseas operation experience to Chinese companies. Do you agree with me? Okay, that's all for today. Please put your comments below and share your insightful ideas with other people. See you.